Dear students, now we are going to discuss double sideband suppressed carrier amplitude modulation.
Let's start with the drawback of double sideband with full carrier amplitude modulation. In the previous lecture video, we discussed about double sideband with full carrier amplitude modulation. In this case, the modulated wave has carrier signal and two sidebands in its spectrum. The total transmitted power is equal to sum of carrier power and sidebands power. So here the powers of sidebands includes both lower sideband and upper sideband power. Most of the power is transmitted in the carrier because carrier power is equal to what here? AC squared by 2R. But the carrier signal does not contain any information. Okay, it is not used for carrying the original information. It is used for carrying the signal. The information is available only in the sidebands. So unnecessarily we are transmitting this carrier power along with the sideband power. Okay, so that is the major drawback in this double sideband with full carrier amplitude modulation. So here, in order to overcome the wastage of transmitted power and bandwidth in full carrier amplitude modulation, we are going to use carrier suppression method. Carrier suppression method means the modulated wave consists of only upper and lower sidebands and the carrier signal is suppressed here. It is amplitude modulation. So amplitude modulation means the amplitude of the carrier is varied in accordance with the modulating signal. Correct. So in this suppressed carrier method, we are going to suppress the carrier signal. So such modulation is called as double sideband suppressed carrier amplitude modulation. So this is the diagrammatic representation of this double sideband suppressed carrier modulator. Message signal is given. Message signal is denoted as M of T. Carrier signal is denoted as C of T. The same conditions are going to be used over here also. That is, carrier frequency should always be greater than modulating frequency. Carrier amplitude should always be greater than modulating amplitude. Okay. So here we can get the double sideband suppressed carrier modulated signal. This is the simple diagram. Next we are going to represent the signals in terms of time domain and we are going to derive the double sideband suppressed carrier amplitude modulated wave. So here M of T, that is the message signal or modulating signal, is equal to AM cos omega MT. AM means what? Amplitude of the modulating signal. Omega M is nothing but what? Angular frequency of the modulating signal. This omega M can also be written as 2 pi FMT. This FM is nothing but modulating frequency. So next, carrier signal can be written as C of T is equal to AC. This is carrier amplitude and cos omega CT. Omega C is the angular frequency of carrier signal. This can also be written as 2 pi FC. FC is the carrier frequency. So here, double sideband suppressed carrier modulated signal is a product of carrier and message signal. Here we are going to product both the signals. Okay, so in the previous full carrier we are going to multiply with the amplitude alone, carrier's amplitude alone, but here we are going to multiply both the message signal and carrier signal, then we can get this value. So M of T is what? AM cos omega MT. C of T is AC cos omega CT. So multiplying both the things we can get AM AC cos omega MT into cos omega CT. We know that cos A cos B is equal to what? 1 by 2 cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. So the same formula can we are going to apply over here. Then we can get the double sideband suppressed carrier suppressed carrier modulated signal S of t is equal to what? AM AC divided by 2. This 2 into cos omega C plus omega M of t plus cos of omega C minus omega M t. Okay. So here we are having only the sidebands. This is what the upper sideband. Here omega C plus omega M. This omega C minus omega M means what? Lower sideband. So here there is no carrier signal. Here we are using only the carrier amplitude. Okay. This is very, very important. This is the equation of double sideband suppressed carrier signal. So next we have to write down the double sideband with suppressed carrier modulated wavers. S of t is equal to AM AC by 2 cos omega C plus omega M of t plus cos omega C minus omega M of t. Okay. So here next, this is we have already derived, right? Double sideband with full carrier. This is for full carrier amplitude modulated signal equation. That is SAM of t is equal to AC cos omega CT plus modulation index. What is MA? It is modulation index into carrier amplitude divided by 2 cos omega C plus omega M plus cos omega C minus omega M T. So here in this full carrier, we are having the carrier signal along with two sidebands. But in this suppressed carrier, this carrier signal is cancelled. That is what very, very important. Okay. So by comparing these two signals, we come to know that, okay, here in this suppressed carrier, okay, so in this suppressed carrier signal is missing. There is no carrier signal in this suppressed carrier. Okay, it is suppressed. And both the sidebands are available with the information. That is what very, very important. That's why we go for suppressed carrier method. So frequency spectrum for this double sideband suppressed carrier amplitude modulation is given like this. Here we are suppressing this carrier signal. That's why I put it like the dot. Okay, there is no signal, carrier signal. The spectrum has only the sidebands. Here upper sideband with FC plus FM. Here lower sideband, that is equal to FC minus FM. Its amplitude is what here? In the suppressed carrier wave is AM AC by 2. So we can write like this. Okay. So next, the bandwidth. Bandwidth of this suppressed carrier method is having 2FM. Bandwidth is nothing but 2 times the modulating frequency. That can be obtained like this. So bandwidth means what? The range of frequencies between upper sideband and lower sideband. So we can substitute this values here. FC plus FM minus FC minus FM. Then FC, FC cancel. We can get 2 times FM. Even in full carrier, in double sideband with full carrier, also the bandwidth is equal to what? 2 times FM. So in this, we are only suppressing the carrier, but the bandwidth is same. Okay, so that is the drawback in this suppressed carrier method. The bandwidth is same. We are only suppressing the carrier. By suppressing the carrier in the spectrum, we can reduce the power using for this carrier in transmitted power, by which we can increase the power of sidebands. Okay. So next, power distributions in double sideband suppressed carrier method. In this double sideband suppressed carrier amplitude modulation method, the carrier is suppressed. Therefore, the total transmitted power is given like this. The total transmitted power has only the powers of sidebands, lower sideband and upper sideband. So, which are having the information, correct? So, here the power of lower sideband is MA, that is modulation squared into carrier amplitude squared divided by 8R. This is, we have already got it in our amplitude modulation signal. So, the same power can be used for upper sideband. Both the sidebands are having same amplitude, same power. So we can get, add these two value, we can get MA squared AC squared by 4R. So that is equal to, we can write MA squared by 2 into AC squared in by 2R. This can be written like this. Okay. So this 4 can be written as 2 into 2. So MA squared by 2 and the remaining terms are AC squared by 2R. What is AC squared by 2R? It is nothing but carrier power. So here the total transmitted power is equal to modulation index squared divided by 2 into carrier power. So this is the total power of, this is the total power of AM with full carrier. This is for full carrier. For this full carrier, the transmitted power value is equal to PC plus PC of 1 plus MA squared by 2. That means what? Here we can write PC plus PC MA squared by 2. So there is one more carrier signal. This carrier signal is cancelled in this suppressed carrier method. This is for with full carrier. Okay. So how much power we are going to save by using this suppressed carrier means, we can take the amplitude modulated power with the full carrier. This is for with full carrier minus with the suppressed carrier divided by the full carrier power. So we can substitute the values here. PC of, this is what, the total transmitted power of AM with full carrier. This is what? Suppressed carrier. Okay. Just now we have derived, right? So here we can, in the numerator, we can multiply inside. We can get PC plus PC MA squared by 2 minus this MA squared by 2 into PC. So here this is plus, this is minus, same term. We can cancel each other and this PC and this PC cancel. Then in the numerator we are having 1. So 1 divided by 1 plus MA squared by 2. So this is what the power savings in double sideband with suppressed carrier. So in terms of percentage, we can write like this. The percentage of power saving is equal to 1 divided by 1 plus modulation index squared divided by 2 into 100. Percentage means we are going to multiply with 100 and we can take the LCM. So here in the denominator, it becomes 1 divided by 2 plus MA squared divided by 2. This 2 goes to the numerator. So we can get 2 divided by 2 plus MA squared into 100. If modulation index is equal to 1. Modulation index is equal to 1 means what? For 100% modulation. For 100% modulation, depth of modulation, that means what? The amplitude amplitude of the carrier signal is equal to amplitude of the modulating signal. This is the condition for 100% modulation. So for MA, that is modulation index is equal to 1 means this value becomes 2 divided by 2 plus 1. Correct. Then it is 2 by 3. 2 by 3 means what? It is 0.66. It's going on like this, 0.6666. So we can take the values like this, 0.667. Okay, so then the percentage is equal to what? 66.7%. So the power saving by 66.7%, we can say that as the transmission efficiency of the DSP SC signal. This is nothing but what? It is the transmission efficiency. So here, transmission efficiency of the double sideband with a suppressed carrier is 66.7%. So in this double sideband suppressed carrier amplitude modulation, 66.7% of power is saved due to the suppression of the carrier wave. Advantages of double sideband suppressed carrier amplitude modulation. It is more efficient. Its transmission efficiency is very high. That is 66.7% in compared with the full carrier amplitude modulation. In full carrier amplitude modulation, it is only 33.3%. But here it is the 66.7%. 7%. We can say this much power is saved, and it has better signal to noise ratio also. These all are the advantages of double sideband suppressed carrier method. It is having one major disadvantage also. As I told you earlier, wastage of bandwidth, because it is having the bandwidth of 2 times the modulating frequency, but it is not required. This much bandwidth is not required for amplitude modulation, but still it is having 2 times the modulating frequency. So the wastage of bandwidth, it is the major drawback in this double sideband with suppressed carrier method. So next important one is generation of double sideband suppressed carrier. So here we know that double sideband suppressed carrier is a product of message signal and carrier signal. So this signal can be generated by using balanced modulator and ring modulator. We are going to discuss about this balanced modulator and ring modulator in detail in the next video. Okay.